Greetings. This is a particular issue I've heard raised before, Brother Abdullah. You ask, why do you follow your God when Bible says God is a deceiver? Jeremiah 4:10. Brother, we need to first see what Jeremiah 4:10 actually says. So let us look at a couple of translations. The King James. Then said I, ah, Lord God, surely thou hast greatly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying, you shall have peace, whereas the sword reaches unto the soul. The NIV. Jeremiah 4:10. Then I said, alas, sovereign Lord, how completely you have deceived this people and Jerusalem by saying, you will have peace, when the sword is at our throats. The Holman Christian Standard, Jeremiah 4:10. I said, oh no, Lord God, you have certainly deceived this people and Jerusalem by announcing you will have peace while a sword is at our throats. If that is the only thing you were told, Abdullah, I can fully understand your thinking. But there are several mistakes Islam has made reading this verse, brother. If you watch many of my videos, you will see that I emphasize the context. So let us examine the context of Jeremiah 4:10. Jeremiah 4:1. If you will return, O Israel, declares the Lord, then you should return to me. And if you will put away your detested things from my presence and will not waver, return, because Israel has turned away from God. Put away your detestable things. That does not sound like a promise of peace. And you will swear, as the Lord lives, in truth, in justice, and in righteousness, then the nations will bless themselves in him, and in him they will glory. For thus says the Lord to the men of Judah and to Jerusalem, break up your fallow ground and do not sow among thorns. Fallow ground is unused, worthless. Circumcise yourselves to the Lord and remove the foreskins of your heart, men of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem, or else my wrath will go forth like fire and burn with none to quench it, because of the evil of your deeds. Circumcise your hearts. Cut off your evil thinking and your evil intentions. These do not sound like a promise of peace either. Declare in Judah and proclaim in Jerusalem and say, blow the trumpet in the land, cry aloud and say, assemble yourselves and let us go into the fortified cities. That sounds like a command to hide. Lift up a standard toward Zion. Seek refuge. Do not stand still, for I am bringing evil from the north and great destruction. For I am bringing great destruction. That does not sound like a promise of peace to me, brother. This is a judgment, a warning, and a threat. A lion has gone up from his thicket, and a destroyer of nations has set out. He has gone out from his place to make your land a waste. Your cities will be ruins without inhabitant. That does not sound like a promise of peace to me, brother. For this, put on sackcloth, lament and wail, for the fierce anger of the Lord has not turned back from us. The fierce anger of God does not sound like peace to me, Brother Abdullah. It shall come about in that day, declares the Lord, that the heart of the king and the heart of the princes will fail, and the priests will be appalled, and the prophets will be astounded. That sounds like shock and awe to me, brother. Then I said, ah, Lord God, surely you have utterly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying, you will have peace, whereas a sword touches the throat. So pay attention to the context, brother. Verses 1 through 9 are not a promise of peace, are they? Please read it again, brother, if you forgot what they said. Repent! Turn back! Destruction is coming! Your king and princes will be stunned! Jeremiah brought a message of judgment, warning, and destruction. But the other men who claimed to be prophets brought false messages of peace. You see, Abdullah, false prophets have always tried to speak for Allah. A false prophet brings a false message that does not lead you to return to Yahweh. And Jeremiah had to know his message, which was not very pleasant, was fighting the false message of peace from the false prophets. Let us look at Jeremiah 4:10 one more time. Then I said, Ah, Lord God, surely you have utterly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying, You will have peace, whereas a sword touches the throat. Notice this is Jeremiah saying this, not God. Jeremiah has not said in this verse, The word of God came to me. Then I, Jeremiah, said to God. Jeremiah is speaking back to God. Ah, Lord God, surely you have utterly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying you will have peace. If the message of peace by the false prophets were true, if in fact God did send the false message of peace by the false prophets, then God did deceive Israel. The critical fact from the context is that God's real message was of judgment, wrath, and coming destruction. So Jeremiah is not saying that God is a deceiver. Jeremiah is saying if the false message of peace were from God, God would be a deceiver. But let's look a little more at Jeremiah's real message from God. Jeremiah 14:10. Thus says the Lord to this people, Even so they have loved to wander. They have not kept their feet in check. Therefore the Lord does not accept them. Now he will remember their iniquity and call their sins to account. So the Lord said to me, Do not pray for the welfare, for the good of this people. When they fast, I am not going to listen to their cry. And when they offer burnt offering and grain offering, I am not going to accept them. Rather, I am going to make an end of them by the sword, famine, and pestilence. But, Ah, Lord God, I said, Look, the prophets are telling them, You will not see the sword, nor will you have famine, but I will give you lasting peace in this place. The prophets, the other prophets, are telling them peace. Then the Lord said to me, The prophets are prophesying falsehood in my name. I have neither sent them, nor commanded them, nor spoken to them. They are prophesying to you a false vision, divination, futility, and the deception of their own minds. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the prophets, who are prophesying in my name, although it was not I who sent them. Yet they keep saying, There will be no sword or famine in this land. By sword and famine, those prophets shall meet their end. So, Abdullah, I want you to really understand what this verse is saying. False prophets were bringing a false message of peace, but the real message from God was of judgment and coming destruction. God said that the false prophets would die by the sword. Abdullah, the message of Jeremiah is clear, brother, and it can be understood if one wants the truth of God's message. This understanding is not something secret or hidden, Brother Abdullah. It is clear and obvious to any man who desires the truth and is willing to read and study. It is clear to me, brother, that Islam does not value the truth. That is why Islam teaches things that are so clearly wrong. I pray, Abdullah, that you will honestly examine what Islam tells you. I show you over and over, brother, that what Islam tells you is false. Like the false prophets that faced Jeremiah, Islam's claims die when they face the truth, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.